now, our next performer, Art of the Ballet instructor, Lunachix and Dark Side of the Moon.
Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. Hello, dear hearts. This is the ghost of Cruella de Vil, coming to the Art of the Ballet to tell my story. My character has been maligned for years, and ultimately resulted in my death yesterday evening. You see, my dear schoolmate, Anita, made up all of that 101 Dalmatians drivel because she was upset that her dogs liked me better than her. When I would puppy sit, they never wanted to go back home, and she had an active imagination, did dear Anita. I came to the Art of the Belly for a bit of belly dance and fun, to visit my good friend RTB. When I arrived, I realized there was quite a congregation of villains present, something about an after party. But as I am not really a villain, I'm not so active in the network. Well, last night, after my intensive, I was settling into the hot tub right here at the carousel when my fate befell me. I saw a bright white light, and then I knew I was in heaven. How did I know, you might ask? I knew because my beloved dog, Danny Dots, was there waiting for me. She left her canine coil last year, and as we all know, all dogs go to heaven. I've come back to seek your help in catching the killer. There were 8 villains in the hot tub yesterday evening. I present them to you now for your review.
Our first suspect to the stage is Catwoman. Catwoman enjoys posts both for scratching and for whipping. She says your best friend in any tricky situation is a cat suit so tight it squeaks. Our next villain to the stage is Nancy from the crowd. She enjoys casting spells, the color black, and shoplifting with friends. The key to successful villainry, according to Nancy, is invoking the spirit of Manon. Next villain to our stage is Dr. Evil. Dr. Evil enjoys sharks with frickin' laser beams on their heads. She wants people to know that she really does love Scott, and she thinks the key to successful villainry is placing your hostages in easily escapable situations with minimal consequences. Next up, we have a group submission. When Boris and Natasha aren't cooking up diabolical plots, they enjoy working on their anthologies, The Joy of Cooking and Mastering the Art of French Cooking. Natasha says the key to successful villainry is disguises, but Boris says, when in doubt, blow it up. Keller enjoys unleashing infinity upon the universe as well as limitless astral projection. She wishes people knew that she had her fingers crossed behind her back when she made a pact with death. She says the successful key to villainry is her magical cloak, along with a strict nighttime ritual involving the oil of Olay. Our last two suspects to the stage entered the contest individually.
But ever since they met on Tinder yesterday evening, they've been inseparable. Ursula wants you to never underestimate the importance of body language, and Captain Hook advises TikTok. It's always a good idea to get started following your diabolical dreams. So you see, I do need your help, dear heart, so I can rest in peace at the great furrier in the sky. You'll find in your programs a game card, complete with a list of suspects, motivations, and weapons. Your mission, dear ones, is to collect information from the vendors. You see, they are really an elite task force that just happen to sell delicious things. If you show them your game card, they can give you a small bit of information. You'll eventually discover the truth by the process of elimination. Present your completed game card to the Lunachix at the after party and see what lies in store. All right now, remember, every bad girl is a little good, and every good girl a little bad. Toot toot.
Lunachix. So yes.